distance the toll. The moon and its eclipse, and Superman unrolls the suit before he lived. But I'm not the kind of person that it fits. She said, where'd you wanna go? How much you wanna risk? I'm not looking for somebody with some superhuman gifts. Some superhero, some fairy tale bliss. Just something I can turn to, somebody I can miss.
Can everyone hear? Great. Welcome to Bridgend Farmhouse and also to the Bridgend Farmhouse Community Workshops. This is kind of like, as well as being our third hard hat tour, it's part of the farmhouse renovation. It's also like the inauguration, the welcoming, the opening of these workshop spaces. And it's like the first time basically as an organization in about 7 years, we've actually had a roof over our heads that's not potentially going to fall in, and you know, like a space that we can gather. So yeah, my name's Will. I'm the chairperson for the charity Bridgend Inspiring Growth. We were set up, as I said, about 7.5 years ago to take ownership of this land and to renovate the building into a community owned and run centre for learning, eating and exercise, with the aims of sort of addressing health inequalities in the area, reducing social isolation. That kind of ethos runs deep in the project and is partly what influences what's going to go on in the building and you know, what's going to happen in these workshops and on the land itself. And then I'm going to pass over to Graham, who's our build manager. And Graham's going to tell us a bit about the build and the renovation, and then we can answer any questions you've got, and then people can go on a tour and see inside the farmhouse mid-process, because we're 2/3 of the way through the full renovation, due for completion around mid-November. And this is our final hard hat tour, so it's the last chance to see inside whilst the work's happening before it gets handed over, and then we're going to call on all of you to come and paint and decorate it. So, stay close.
Yeah, it's been quite an extensive refurbishment, first of all, the farmhouse. It was built sometime in the 1700s or 1800s. So the build in the farmhouse went all the way back to the stonework. We took out floors, we took all of the roof timbers off other than the trusses and the rafters and things that were holding it up. We demolished a chimney and rebuilt it. And then we'll slowly put it back together again. We've got underfloor heating, and then lots of concrete, lots of insulation. We've got some special sort of non-synthetic insulation, if you like, in the walls, which I'll show you.
Something about where Bridgend is, and it's not in the heart of Craigmillar, it's not in the heart of the Inch. It sits in between different communities, and that, I suppose, allows it to feel that it's not embedded within one area. And so maybe there's less territorialism, there's less sense of like, I can't go there, or I can't go here, or whatever. So it's allowing other people from across the city to come as well.
Anyone else for the tour?
Just before we go, just a couple of housekeeping things. First of all, as a live building site, the guys are working even though it's Friday afternoon. So particularly watch your feet, because there's lots of loose stones and things around. It is Friday after all.
No, Tuesday.
Where'd you wanna go? How much you wanna risk?
Chris won a sunny day, yeah?
Now, I started with Big in April last year. My first board meeting was in May. So I turned up after doing a day's work in my suit and tie, not knowing it was going to be in a freezing cold farmhouse, you know, heating. So ever since then, I've turned up with anoraks and scarves and lots of other things. The insulation, which is breathable, is very important with old buildings because they're designed to breathe. They don't have the kind of air tightness of normal construction now. At the moment, we've got all the cabling in, but we've got nothing over the top, no what we call the second fix. So it's a different kind of regime, and bigger, we're going to have to understand that the heating in the colder months will be on all the time, but just at a very low level, just constantly heating the building, keep the building warm, and keeping the air inside it and the people warm.
Four workshops. This one will be, hopefully, a DIY wood metalwork centre where people can rent space, community projects can run from here. Then we've got an arts and crafts workshop, a bike workshop, and then a centre for outdoor education at the end. So lots of resources for using in the park and things. A community cafe, a training kitchen to go with it, your meeting room, or maybe sort of a hub for office space upstairs, an events space, and then dance class and that kind of thing upstairs. And then we've got parking on the other side, which will probably, as you've seen today, be more popular than everything else, unfortunately.
Too far as you have to walk, I just parked up the road.
But just keep in touch, please. And as I said, you know, we're working away. There's lots of stuff there, but we are still, you know, there are things that there are issues that we need to be working on. We're looking for partners with. We need to restore the wall. We're looking at pedestrian crossing because it's an issue for people to get across here. We're trying to kit out these workshops and get them up and running.
So I think you're doing a great job.